Hello. Okay, today we're going to talk about graphing linear equations with two variables. In previous vlogs, we've discussed how to solve for y and solve for x. What we'll do today is we have an equation with x and y in the equation. And these represent points on the line. With the x and y pair, with the solution to this equation, we'll create a picture which is a straight line. X plus 2y equals 7. This is our equation. It's a linear equation. Both variables are in the first power. The picture we see is the picture for the solutions to this equation. If we look at x equals 1 and were to replace it in this equation, we would get x equals 3, y equals 3, and so on and so forth. Each pair you see on this board are solutions for this equation. Now, we're going to test x equals 3, y equals 2. And how we test, if you remember, is if we end up with 7 equals 7, that means this pair is a solution for this equation. As we said, we see 7 equals 7. It's a true statement. What that means is the point 3 comma 2 is a solution to that equation. And is also, if you notice, is on the line. Every pair you see here, if I were to replace each pair in this equation, you would get 7 equals 7 every time. This picture represents all possible answers to this equation. In the next example, I'm going to give you the numbers for the answers for x, and you're going to find the answers for y. We have our table and our equation. 3x plus 2y equals negative 6. We're going to replace x with these three values and solve for y. We'll do one together. So we see that we have replaced x with negative 4, and we're going to find what the value y value is. This is negative 12 plus 2y equals negative 6. And here we have y equals 3. X is negative 4, and we're saying y equals 3. Normally I would say we have to check this, but we're going to wait. And we're going to see what happens and see if our answer is, some of our answers are not accurate. Now, suppose x equals 0. We're going to place x with 0. What we find is we have, when x is equal to 0, we get y equals to negative 3. We'll put it back on the table. Now we have the last pair to fill out. I'm going to erase it here to save some space, working space. Now we see we've replaced 1 with x, or x with 1. 3 times 1 is 3, plus 2y equals negative 6. Now we're going to solve for y. Now we finally have completed the table. We have three pairs, which represent three different points on the graph. We're going to graph these three points on our graph and look at the shape of what we see. It should be a straight line, and that'll tell us if we're right or not. If we have a shape or a line that's not straight, then we've made a mistake somewhere. But if it is straight and we have done the work correctly. So before I proceed, we can see that we have 3 points here, and they appear to be in a straight line. Now, this wasn't the best drawing for me. It was hard to see my grid, but we'll use a line, straight line from our program here and see if it hits all the 3 points. Okay. It's a little off here, but it's really in the right place. Not because my math is wrong, but my drawing is a little off. This line represents the equation. So, thank you. That's enough for today, and this is our example.